Hey guys, this is Mark. In this video, I will be talking about adding data to your backendless database. There are different ways to do that. One of them is by using Management Console, and I briefly showed that in one of the previous videos. The other one is the most interesting one. It is by using the API. Before we go into it, let's talk about the actual mechanics of what it means to get data into the backendless database. In the previous video, I talked about database schema. If you remember, we looked into the entity of person and identified various properties that identify a person. And then after that, we took those properties and created columns in the person table. This is the table, person table, and this is our schema, so we identified these columns. Why I'm describing this? Well, because this is important when you store data in Backendless Database. The columns here, or the properties that you identified that represent one or the other entity, become crucial when you store data in Backendless Database. I do have a little visualization here just to kind of put it all together more graphically. And let me switch to a slide that you have seen before. Sort of a version of that slide. Back then we looked into the person entity, and these were the properties that we came up with. So when you work with the API or even just the management console to put data into the database manually, you're going to be working with these properties. And then from the API perspective, what's going to be important is that all of these properties are going to be packaged together into what we call an object. An object is like one unit that contains multiple properties and their values. And then you'll be sending that object to the database, and database just stores it as a record. Let's go back to Backendless Console. Back in console here, if we go to the data browser, let's take a look at how you could enter the data manually. For this, we already have these columns defined for our entity called person. If you click the new menu icon, a row is created, and in this row you'll just be typing up or selecting data that you want to store in that record. So here, if we select just some arbitrary date, and that's going to be the date of birth for that person, then age, we can select the eye color, all right, and type in the name, and let's say add weight. So at this point, a record is created, and it has all these values for the columns that represent a person. Once the record is in, all other APIs for retrieving data from the database, for modifying this record, if needed, deleting it, are instantly available. And we will be looking into those APIs in separate videos. Right now, we're focusing on just creating data. So, and that's the manual insertion of data. The other way to do it is by using the API. If you use an external system, some UI development system where you build your UIs and you interact and integrate with Backendless through the APIs, you will be using REST API. And REST stands for Representational State Transfer. It's not that critical that you kind of know what REST stands for. It's just kind of interesting and sometimes maybe important to know. But anyway, with REST, there is a what we call an endpoint URL, which is the URL where the request is sent to, and there is a body. Sometimes there is a body, sometimes there is no body. In this case, when you add data, it is important that there is a body of that request, and that body is going to be a JSON object. So here, if I switch to REST console, the person table is created. The request URL, this is kind of the part of the URL. You can click on this show full URL. You will see the full URL where the request goes out to. The important thing is going to be right here in request body. I prepared a JSON object that looks like this. And this is the format of JSON format for an object that starts with curly braces. And this is JSON object. JSON array is going to be different. Basic values are going to be different for, let's focus on objects. So curly braces, and then with comma separated format, we have these pairs where we identify the name of the column or the property of that object, then colon, and then there is a value. Okay, so for eye color, we have black. Notice that black is in surrounded by double quotes, meaning that this value is going to be string. For weight and for age, there are no double quotes. And this is a numeric value, okay? Because our columns for weight and age, we define them as int. They are integers. Date of birth is a column of type date time. And for date time, there are different ways you can specify that value. I chose to use this string that has a special format where we have month, date, and then the year. And Backendless processes that value and stores it as date time in its system. So now once you have this JSON object, click put, the request, this request body, that object goes to the database, database stores it as a record, and then returns the actual database record again in the JSON format. And it added some system level properties such as object ID, updated, and created, which is a timestamp when that record was created. Notice that the date of birth, this date, was modified and is now stored as this long number. This long number is a timestamp, and it's a timestamp that represents how many milliseconds passed since January 1, 1970. And that's just a kind of internal thing in Backendless. We will look into date time values once we get to individual videos for the data types. Now, if I go to data browser, you'll see that now we have a record for Anna. This is the record that was created with all of the values that we had in JSON now stored as a record in the database. So that's REST. If you use any of our SDKs, there will be an API for Android, for iOS, for Flutter, for .NET that provide exactly the same functionality. However, with UI Builder, things are even simpler because if you do it in our cloud code, it's going to be the same way using Codeless to store data in the database. And for this, I will switch to the front end section. And here I have an empty page where I will add a button. And the title of that button will be Save Object. When this button is clicked, I want to add a logic that will be executed to save an object in the Backendless database. So let's do this. Click on this icon. The logic opens up. There has a bunch of different events. The one that we're interested in is called onClick event. This is the event that is triggered whenever button is clicked. And in here, we will add logic to save data in Backendless. All the database-related APIs and the functionality in Codeless that relates to saving data in the database or working with data in the database is going to be under Data API. Click on that, and there is this block, Save Object in Backendless. Drag it out, and then we will specify the name of the table where we want to store it. And notice that the second input is going to be an object. And that object we'll create through this object, create object block. Click the gear icon, and here we will be identifying the properties or column names that exist in that table. So here we have name, age, weight, eye color, and date of birth. So now for every single property that we specified here, by the way, the capitalization needs to be exactly the same as you created those columns in the schema. So if we have name as all lowercase, then the name, as a column name, then the name as a property in the subject needs to be spelled out exactly the same way using the same capitalization of letters. So now we will provide values for these properties. Name and eye color are strings. So if we search for text, we get the block that contains string. Okay, so here if we have George as the name and the eye color, let's say it's going to be green. Age and weight are numeric values. Remember, they were ints. So for this, if we go to math and grab this block, so the age, let's say it's going to be 34, and then weight we'll put as 180 pounds. Date of birth is the date time value. So for this, if we go to date, we have this block that converts to date object from string. So let's create a string that will be 08/10/1994. So now this object is complete. It has all these property names and values. This object goes into the block save object in Backendless, and this block takes that object, sends it to the database where it is converted into a record in the person table. Let's run this page. So this is the page. I will open up inspect panel and switch to network so we can see the actual traffic that goes out to the server. Click Save Object. this is the request that was sent. You can see the request URL, all the headers, and then this is the response that the database sent us back. And there is this object ID and then system level properties. So at this point, if I switch to backend, we'll have this additional George record that was created using codeless APIs. And there you have it. So this is a kind of a demonstrates different ways how to get data into the backendless database. I hope you found this video useful. There are many more coming. Thank you for watching this video, and as always, happy coding.